I'm Frank Cummins, and I'm caretaker of the Egg Hill Church. I'm actually from down around Westchester. I moved up here about 18 years ago. I ring the bell every Sunday morning about 9 o'clock, and we clean up for weddings and whatever we have, and we have open house. Last Sunday in September. It keeps us busy with the mischief that's going on at the church, so we have to take care of that.
How do you feel about all the vandalism?
Well, there's not much we can do. It's a sorry situation, you know. I mean, we try to catch them, and we just don't succeed. They're in and out, you know. They come in and ring the bell, and they're gone. By the time the neighbors get out, they're gone. So it's pretty bad. But usually the signs don't mean much. We put no trespassing and signs of it. Sometimes they just tear them down.
A lot of people have gone there and done vandalism. How do you feel about that?
I really don't think it's respectful to the church itself, but I mean, they get prosecuted for it and punished, so.
There's a lot of vandalism there. How do you feel about that?
I don't really care if they can vandalize it. I probably won't, just because I said I don't want to mess with that, but anyone else can vandalize it all they want. I don't really care.
I do know one story about the bell getting stolen out of the bell tower.
It was about 2 o'clock on the 4th of July that they come up here, and they climbed up the ladder up here, and they took the bell, and they threw it out the steeple up here, and it hit the stone here, and it kind of cracked it up. So they took it on down to where they lived, and...
And then a few days later, like, his mom found out and was like, you really need to go take this back and tell them what happened. And so he gave it back, and he did end up get prosecuted for it.
And we got it back, and a man from Pleasant Gap, he fixed it all up for us, and we had it back up there.
What do you know about the myths that have been, and the rumors that are being spread about the church?
Well, I just hear them from the college. I hear a lot of the college kids come out, and they hear all kind of rumors about someone, minister killed the congregation and all that, so that's all I hear about it.
So you only know, like, what?
Yeah, I only know what I hear, yeah.
My name is Luann Benner. I am a clerk at Jadun's Country Place in Spring Mills.
How long have you been in this area?
52 years.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Your whole life?
Lifetime, yes.
Okay, and then what do you know about Egg Hill?
Only the stories that I've heard, that it's supposed to be haunted, and, you know, there's always somebody trying to do damage to something that is of historical value.
Have you had any personal experiences in the church that have any, like, paranormal, like,
no,
things?
No, not really, no, no, no.
Do you have any idea where they might have, like, gotten the idea that?
I don't know. I had no idea where that came from.
So that, there's no truth.
No, they say there's no truth in it, no. It's dark up here. It's really dark up here. But no, I'm not afraid.
So how do you feel about all the vandalism then?
I don't like it. I was never a hellraiser myself, and I don't really think people should do that kind of stuff. Like I said, history is history. Let it alone. You know, there's enough of other ways to, if they have to get in trouble, to get in trouble. They don't need to destroy property that is of history.
See him covering it up. It might be an old wives' tale, but it's so widely known, and it's on the internet and everything. So I kind of believe him.
You believe that?
I believe the stories.
So why do you think he would say that they're not true then?
I'm not sure. Maybe just because he doesn't want anybody to come and vandalize it. Or I know it's got to be tough, like all the high schoolers, not just from State College, but from like Penns Valley and Bellefonte and just all the high schools around here. That's like the big thing to go, is go see Egg Hill Church and see what you can see and see if the stories are true. And that's got to be a lot of like upkeeping to keep them out of there.
I'd probably go there. I don't know if I'd ever go in. I might just go there, though, just to say that I've been there and looked at it. And I don't know if I would go in, though.
Why not?
I don't know. I guess it's still, like, in the back of my head, even though you don't know if it's real. It could be. I don't know. I sometimes don't think I ever want to mess around with that stuff.
Yeah, I would go there just to see what it was like. I think it'd be interesting to go and see what other people have told me, see if it's true or not. Thank you.